Okay, so here are my round two predictions and round one recap for the NBA playoffs. Yes, round two has already begun. Last night, the Celtics defeated the Sixers in game one of the semifinals, but I'm still going to make my predictions anyway for the rest of all of the teams and go over round one. So, to start with round one, the Bulls and Sixers. One of the all-time shockers in NBA playoff history, the Sixers come over the Bulls in six games. Definitely a surprise, but the main reason for this, in my honest opinion, is the very fact that Derrick Rose went down in game one by tearing his ACL. Joakim Noah also went down later in the series, and Philadelphia managed to get up in the series 3-1 at one point after Chicago took the first game. Chicago came back and took game five at home, but Philly pulled one out at the last second with a couple of free throws in game six. A surprise, only the fifth time in NBA history that the eighth seed has come back and beat the one seed. And you know what? I think if the Bulls had everybody, they would have won the series, but it just goes to show that, a couple of players can't make your team. You know, you have to be able to win without just one or two players. I don't think the Bulls are that weak, but I'm just saying. It kind of makes you look pretty weak if just a couple of guys go down and you end up losing the series. They should have been able to win the series. I was surprised. The Heat and Knicks, this was an easy one for Miami. They took it in five. Absolutely no surprise here. The Knicks won one game at home, and they won by just one field goal. The first three games were blowouts. Well, the second game wasn't that bad of a blowout, but the first game, 100-67. The third one, 87-70. Even the second one was 10 points, and the last one was 12. So every game that Miami won was by better than 10 points. So they really just dominated the Knicks, who didn't really look very good at all. I thought the Knicks would give them a much harder time than they did, honestly. The Knicks looked horrible. Pacers and Magic. Pacers took the series in five. Orlando took the first game, and I said to myself, well, they took the first game in Indiana, so the Pacers could be in trouble here if they can't close out these games. But Indiana came back and won games 2, 3, 4, and 5, two of which were in Orlando. They actually beat Orlando by 23 in their own in game 3, 97-74. They pulled out game 4 by only one field goal, and they won the last one by 18. And so this series, and they won the second game by 15. So, most of the games that Indiana won were by big margins again. So Orlando didn't look very good here. Without Dwight Howard, they just aren't very strong. Glenn Davis is the best they can do in their middle without Dwight Howard. So they were in trouble from the start without him. And they're a good team, just not a great team. And Indiana has had a hell of a season, and they proved why they deserve to be the number three seed in this series, pretty much dominating Orlando outside of game one. The Celtics and Hawks, this was actually a pretty good series. Atlanta took game one after the Celtics just completely played like crap. 83-74, this was in Atlanta. No surprise that Atlanta wins one of the two games at home. They got home advantage because they had the better record. It's a rarity when you see the 5 seed get the home advantage over the 4 seed just because they have the better record. Well, it's more, you'll see it in the 4 and 5 seed more than you would in any other place. And then Boston came back and took game 2 after a great fourth quarter. Game 3 was a win for the Celtics as well. They won by a couple of field goals. And then they destroyed the Hawks in game 4 in Boston. Man, they came out and shot the lights out. Unbelievable. So they took a 3-1, commanding 3-1 series lead. Atlanta comes back and wins game 5 by just 1 point. Even though the Celtics stole the ball with 10 seconds to go in game 5 and Rondo lost it out of bounds. So Atlanta took the fifth game and made it 3-2. And then the Celtics won the last one. Barely squeezed it out, 83-80, to take the series in 6, as I predicted. Celtics played pretty good. They looked good. And they won the first game in round 2 already. So they're looking good. Spurs and Jazz, move to the Western Conference. Spurs swept the Jazz and made the Jazz look horrible in every single one of the games. They absolutely destroyed the Jazz. So I don't need to say anything further. The Jazz, fuck, the Spurs just came out and played. You know, they did the opposite of what they did last year in the first round. They just dominated it, as you would have predicted. Spurs looked very good at the end of this season, and like last year, they looked bad toward the end of the year, and then that killed them in the playoffs. And this year, they looked stronger than ever, and they, wow, they're looking good. They got a lot of time to rest between round one and round two, which could affect them a little more in round two. Thunder and Mavericks. Thunder swept the Mavericks. These games were close, though. Outside of game three, every game was decided by like only a couple of field goals. Game one was a one-point win for Oklahoma when Kevin Durant hit the buzzer beater. You know, like things like that. You know, they were just close games. The second game was 102-99, and game four was 103-97. And then, you know, Dallas got beat in their own on their own court twice in a row. So Oklahoma City is a strong young team, and they prove why they are. They just outlasted Dallas, but Dallas still put up a fight. So it looks like, wow, that was a crazy sweep. That was easy. It really wasn't. The Mavericks were close. They just never got the win. Lakers and Nuggets was a great series, as I would have said. Well, not really that amazing, but it went all seven games, and Lakers took the first two at home, and I said, well, maybe Denver won't give them that hard of a time. Well, game two was pretty close, but game one was, yeah, not very good for Denver. But Denver came back and beat L.A. by 15, and then L.A. came back and beat them by 4 in Denver, so they split in Denver, and L.A. was up 3-1, a pretty commanding lead. And then Denver came back and won in L.A. in Game 5, and then won by 17 in Game 6 in Denver. So I have all the scores written down. But yeah, I mean, that's pretty damn good. Denver to come back and win in L.A. and then win Game 6, tie this thing up, force a Game 7. L.A. ended up pulling it out last night and taking the series. But Denver really gave him a hard time, like I would have thought. And then the Clippers-Grizzlies series was one of the best series that there was. These games were all tight. The first game had to be the most exciting, though. The LA Clippers made a huge comeback. They were down by more than 27 points, and they came back and won the game in the fourth quarter, 99-98. It was unbelievable. And that was in Memphis, too. Memphis took game two, so they were split, like you might have thought. Going into LA. LA took both games at home by 1 point at a buzzer beater, and then they took the second one by only 4 to go up 3-1. Memphis came back and won games 5 and 6, one at home and one on the road. In game 6, I believe Blake Griffin had to leave the game, and so did Chris Paul. And then game 7 today, the Clippers took out Memphis 82-72 to take the series. So a very tight series there from start to finish, and a couple of nice Western Conference series. Even though I don't think either one of those teams will make it past round two, those were great series. Playoffs round one were pretty predictable. I believe I got 7 out of 8 correct for teams that would move on to the next round. The only one I got wrong was the Bulls. But, of course, I didn't know Derrick Rose was going to get hurt. So, here are the round two predictions. So, if we'll go to the Eastern Conference first, I'm going to say the Miami Heat defeat the Indiana Pacers, because it's Heat, Pacers, and Boston Celtics versus Philadelphia 76ers. Western Conference is Spurs and Clippers, and Thunder and Lakers. So I'm going to say the Heat beat the Pacers in 6. I think the Pacers will definitely take at least both the home games that they have. They might force a Game 7, but I'm saying that Miami's still going to take this series in 6, but I could see it going to 7. The Indiana Pacers are a tough team. They're going to give Miami a hard time. I definitely think they're going to bother Miami. They might, if they take one of the games in Miami in the first two, I think they very well could make this a 7-game series. But Miami looked very good in the first round. Then again, they were playing the Knicks, who looked like shit in the first round. So there's no, yeah, I can't really say that, you know. But Indiana looked very good and has had an amazing turnaround season from last year. So I say that's going to go 6, at least 6 games, possibly 7. But I'm going to say the Heat, as the overall stronger offensive presence, are going to take this series. Celtics, I believe, will go over the 76ers. I don't think the 8th seed should be, you know, should be beating the 4 seed, especially now that the Celtics have home advantage and they're very, very good on their own court. They took game 1 by 1 point, but this is without even thinking about game 1. If the Celtics, I mean, here's what I thought before the series, I'll let you know, because I already made my predictions in my head. If the Celtics take the first two games at home, they're going to take this series. I think they will take both games at home, and they already took the first one. They take game two, I say Philadelphia's going to take at least one of their two home games, because Philadelphia's not that weak. They're actually not that weak of an 8 seed. They had a tough go of it at the end of the season, but outside of that, Philadelphia had a pretty damn good year. So they look a little worse than they really are. So I think they'll take at least one of their home games. So I'm going to say the Celtics take it in five, but that's just because I believe the Celtics are playing so freaking well, and they play with so much heart and so much determination that I think that they're going to overcome it in five. That's just because they have home advantage, and with the home advantage, if they win both games at home, I think this will go five. The Celtics will win the last game at home, and that's a good rest for an older team like the Celtics. They could use a rest after a big series with Atlanta, you know, that went six games. They didn't get any rest. They started right up on Saturday night. They just finished the series with Atlanta Thursday night, so no rest for them. But I do think that they'll take this in five, just because they're playing that good right now. No doubt about that. For the Western Conference, I'm going to say the Spurs take out the Clippers, but I'm going to say the Clippers give them a harder time. We're going to say, let's go with six games here. I'm going to say the Spurs got a lot of time off, and I wouldn't be surprised with the Clippers playing as much as they've been playing, and they're a younger team. I'm going to say the Clippers are going to come out and take game one from the Spurs. Spurs will get the redemption in game two, and then we'll see a pretty good series from there, where I think the Clippers and they'll split at both places, and then game five and six will be the Spurs. I think the Spurs will end up taking it on the road. That's right. I know, bold predictions from me, but I like to be bold with my predictions. I said that the Red Sox would come back in 2004 from the Yankees when they were down 3-0, and did they? You bet your ass they came back. Now, I know most people wouldn't believe that I predicted that, but seriously, I did predict that. I wouldn't lie about that. I've never made very many amazing predictions in my life. That was one thing I did right. And then the other series is the Oklahoma City Thunder over... I mean, and I'm not saying that, by the way, I'm not saying that the Spurs winning on the road in LA is that surprising or would be that unbelievable. I'm just saying that's one really bold prediction I happen to make. But I think that the Spurs are a good road team, so them winning in LA won't be surprising. Oklahoma City, I'm going to say, goes over the Lakers. The Lakers, honestly, Denver gave them a very hard time, and Oklahoma City is a good amount better than Denver is. So I'm going to say Oklahoma City takes this one probably again in six. This one will go, you know, the Lakers will still win a game or two. They're still a decent team. They're still gonna give them a hard time. There's no doubt about that. But I say that the Thunder will take them out in six. Either... or possibly five. I don't know. But I'm going to say if Oklahoma City takes the first two at home, let's leave it with two possibilities. If Oklahoma City takes both games at home, they're no doubt going to take this in five games. But if they split at home, like I think will happen, we'll see this go to six. Oklahoma will take it on the road in LA in game six. I know I'm saying a lot of road wins for these teams, but I think most of the teams left are good on the road. So that's just my opinion. Except the Celtics were like, meh. But, yeah, you get my point. So, those are my predictions for round two of the NBA playoffs. Let me know what you think of round two by leaving your predictions in the comment section. Also, give me what you thought about round one of the playoffs. Thanks for watching, as always. And subscribe, like, comment, and thank you again for watching, as always.